being a parent through all this stuff, everything that's going on in the country right now, and my gosh, I feel like the coronavirus isn't even on. I mean, people wearing masks to protest, sure, but like, I mean, it's amazing that a global pandemic has really sort of taken almost a back seat to everything else that's happening in the country right now. Being a parent through these times, I don't know, how much do you let your kids watch the news? Bob, do you have them watching it with you? Do you explain what's going on to them?
My son is, he just turned 11. He doesn't have social media or anything. So other than what he sees on the news, or like when he's walking out of the room, we're watching the news, he's not watching the news. My daughter, who's on social media, completely aware of everything that's happening.
Yeah.
So we sat them both down this weekend. You know, I mean, we've had talks with them before, obviously, but just explained, you know, about the protest and about what's going on and about how horrible things can be, for some of their friends or like people that they know, people that we all know.
Yeah.
You know, in America, it's just it's hard to talk about.
It's hard as a parent too, because, you know, obviously if your kids obviously have friends and go to school with kids that they don't get treated the same, and their parents don't get treated the same in this country. And it's
weird though, because my kids are like, our kids in general, you're so pure and oblivious to all of it, you know?
Yeah.
For the most part, it doesn't even cross their mind, any of this, whatever happened to any of their friends.
My daughter posted a picture that was going around on her social media, like, you know, to remember George Floyd. And, you know, I told her, I'm just like, do you know what's all happening? And, you know, obviously I have talked to her about everything that's happening, was explaining that situation. And I asked her, I'm just like, do you know why so many people, not only black people, but people, white people like us and people of all races and ethnicities and background, why they say Black Lives Matter? And she said, yeah. And I go, tell me, because I wanted to know what she was going to say, because I've never asked her, like,
right.
Tell me what you think as a teenager, what Black Lives Matter is. Like, give me an example of what that. And she's like, if you're in a restaurant and somebody has a broken toe, but there's somebody at a table right next to them that's choking, obviously you should pay attention to the person that's choking, because their life is in danger. And you should stop them from choking before you go to the other person who isn't having a life-threatening injury. And when she sort of made that example, even though, you know, two people in a restaurant with injuries, it made me feel good as a parent, like I'm doing an okay job, because that's what it means. It means that, yeah, of course you're going to get the All Lives Matter people, and it's like, you can't even get to that point if you don't first realize that Black Lives Matter, and you have to make them matter. They have to be equal to other lives before you can say that we all matter, because the way that so many people are treated in this country right now, we're telling them they don't matter. We got to make them matter.